Greetings. In this video, we're going to introduce you to the Vonage Contact Center integrated into Salesforce and show you the types of capabilities that we have in terms of creating and customizing dashboards because of the rich amount of data that we write into Salesforce. Before we get in and actually start to look at some dashboards, there's a couple of foundational elements I want to cover. First is really the baseline task or activity records that will, in essence, make up the reports. So every phone call that the Vonage Contact Center processes results in a task or activity record that provides information about the agent who handled the call, any notes that they may have noted, any association to other objects within that Salesforce organization, and then the actual call metadata. And while there is good detailed information, it is somewhat limited in terms of the segmentation, which I'm going to address momentarily as we get into this. But this is the baseline activity record, and we create it for each and every inbound and outbound phone call that gets presented to an actual agent. Now, for many contact centers, they have more advanced reporting requirements, and Vonage has the capability to address those with our advanced reporting package. So in that advanced reporting package, we create an additional record about each and every phone call, and we create it with a lot of granularity and detail so that you can have a lot of actionable data. So there's a quick visual element that helps you understand visually what that call went through, some overall information about the transaction or the call, if there were multiple agents involved, who were they? And then very granular and very accurate and detailed information about all of the different call segmentations. And if two agents were involved, the ability to properly delineate between agent one and agent two's participation in that phone call. So those are the building blocks for the reports and the dashboards that we create within Salesforce. So let's take a look at how we might interact with the dashboards. The Vonage Contact Center comes with, in its basic package, two dashboards out of the box, the call summary outbound and call summary inbound. You would have the ability to open up those dashboards and customize them. I'm not going to do that, but that would be an option that you would have. You do have the ability to create a brand new dashboard, which is what I want to show you. And we'll give that a quick name. Okay, we'll call it My Favorites, and we'll say it's My KPIs. We'll keep it private, and we'll create that. In essence, when you go to create a dashboard, you now have this blank canvas or blank grid, and what you do is add individual reports onto that dashboard as components. And so by nature of that, the dashboard is the highest order of visibility into your data, and it is comprised of multiple reports that feed that dashboard view. So we could add a couple of components to show you how this works. We'll jump into all of the reports in the system. I believe that there are a couple here that I'm going to want to use. I believe there is a call outcome per representative, which I wanted to show. And I want to show that as a donut chart. We'll add that component. We can then add another component. I've got a couple of reports that I created. Actually, they should be right here. Do the calls and interaction. We can add, I think there it is, a quality report. I think there's an abandoned report that we should also be able to get. And bandit calls by hour, perfect. Okay. So we've got all of these components now on our desktop, if you will. You have the ability to now move them around, resize them as you see fit. So I think what I'd like to do is to orient this in such a way where I can get this all in one line. I think if I do this. Okay, so you can see I have a lot of flexibility. I could add more components on here and really make this busy if I wanted to. But that is the baseline way that you can structure and create a dashboard. I'm just going to, I'll just delete this, get out of here. I wanted to bring you to a dashboard I previously built. It has a couple of different things I'd like to show you. So here's a dashboard that I created where I have more components on it. And you can see as I go through this, as I look at my cost to serve component, I can see that there's one or two accounts here that are really skewing my ability to see any of the other accounts in any granularity because they're so much different. So maybe it may make some sense for me to do some customization to improve upon my visibility there. So what I'd like to do is introduce you to the concept of adding filters onto your dashboards. And so in order to do that, we go into the edit function. And this is where we have all of the different components that are now exposed on that grid, just like they were when we started to build the dashboard. I could, you know, grab one of these, delete that if I happen to want to, bring this up in here, maybe resize it so everything fits nicely so we can do that. And maybe I don't need this particular component. So I've cleaned that dashboard up a little bit. And then I want to add a filter so that I can selectively decide if I want to look at these two large accounts within this report or not. And so that's where I have this concept of a filter. So I can go in here and actually go into the filter that's already been established. And that right now is basically saying that I want to look at and have the option of filtering in or out any accounts that contain Vonage or Transamerica. And that's really to capture, that was already on there, this Transamerica within this account name and the Vonage here. So as I complete any edits here, and I didn't make an edit, but just to get out of the dashboard, this is where now that filter becomes live. And I have the ability, as I'm doing now, to look at the data with all of the counts included, or I could filter out those two accounts that were causing my visibility into my other accounts to be much harder to really understand. So those were a couple of concepts we wanted to show: the ability to create and move components around on a dashboard, the ability to put a filter on the dashboard itself, and then users always have the ability to then subscribe to the dashboards of their choosing. So this is where they would have the ability to receive these as, you know, daily, weekly, monthly updates, and they could interact with the data as they see fit from that point forward. So hopefully that's a good example of how you can leverage the data that we put into Salesforce to better understand your contact center and where the opportunities may be for improvement, and how you can use dashboards in order to do so. Thanks for watching.